You know, I mean, they must have realised.
Do you think baseball's derived from cricket?
This lovely absolutely game of rounders that we used to play in England.
Yeah, there's so many similarities. Yeah. The throwing, the batting. In baseball, you play in a park.
In cricket, you play in a ground.
In baseball, you want to go home.
In cricket, after 4 days, you can go home.
In baseball, you run around a diamond.
In cricket, you run back and forth.
In baseball, you throw over a plate.
In cricket, you bowl at the stumps.
In baseball, you are tagged out.
In cricket, you are leg before wicket.
In baseball, there's a seventh inning stretch.
In cricket, there's a tea break.
In baseball, a moving pitch is called a curveball.
In cricket, a moving pitch is called a googly.
In baseball, there are fielders.
In cricket, there is a silly mid-on and a silly mid-off. So in baseball, I guess each fielder has a name, yeah, right? And right, wherever that fielder moves, he's still the third baseman. Right. Or still the shortstop, even if it's a shift and he's moving right over one way. But in cricket, you got 9 guys that you can move, apart from the bowler and the wicketkeeper being the other two. And the place on the field has the name rather than the fielder. So three slips, a silly mid-on, a silly mid-off, a long on, a long off, a square wicket, whatever it is, square leg. These are places on the field that you move people into, rather than that fielder having a certain name.
Right.
So it could change, change ball to ball, basically.
No, Eliza, it's best game ever invented, cricket. Baseball is a dumbed-down version, which makes it, don't get me wrong, and that's not an insult, it makes it a more exciting game. On a temporary level. But cricket is a game of chess. The fact that he's played over 5 days, so you get 5 days to intimidate one man.
It's fine, isn't it?
One man can stay in bat for, let's say 36 hours. It's possible. The whole psychological battle between that guy and the guys that are aiming at his balls, or his head, or his shin, or, trying to break his bones. They're not trying to just gently bowl to him. They're bowling at 100 miles an hour with a piece of concrete. Let's imagine that guy that's in for 36 hours, imagine how the psychological warfare between him and the bowlers. Different bowlers are going to bowl at him. So one particular spinner, for example, might have had him on the ropes. But another bowler, he might have the upper hand against. So there's all kinds of banter going on. And the fast bowlers might get impatient. They might start bowling a bit wildly.
If you're a fast bowler, then you're trying to induce me to play a shot in the idea that it's going to catch the outside of my bat here and go to one of the ring of fielders that I've got, who are there waiting just to pounce on it. So they're going to be looking to pitch a ball so that I'm not quite sure if I should wait for it back here or I should go forwards to it here. And if I get kind of stuck in the middle, a bit of uncertainty, and the bat's just wobbling all over the place, that's when you get that nice edge and you can get me out that way.
Right. Fascinating.
But sometimes you want to bowl it right at my body and pitch it up, in which case I might try and defend myself or I might try and just get the heck out of the way.
What we call sledging, which is invented by the Australians primarily, it's the art of basically being nasty to people for about 3 days.
That's what Nick was always talking about, how they're intimidating him, the batter, going for his head.
Yeah, head if they're being generous. lower than your head if they're... Yeah. If they're being mean about it.
The difference between cricket and baseball is that the ball will move in the air with baseball, but it will move in the air with cricket and then move again once it hits the ground. The thing for me that could be really a bit more interesting in baseball is the ball is much lighter and bigger in baseball. So it's possible to get it moving a lot more in the air.
After sumo wrestling, it's probably the biggest sport in Japan, wouldn't you think? Baseball?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Actually, the biggest game, in Japan during the year is called Koshien, which is the high school championships.
Well, I just like the idea of, it's quite genteel and then you can try and break the guy's face. That's quite good.